Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Welcome this morning to Rockbrook United Methodist. We are glad that you are here. A couple of announcements I would like to lift up. We have a freezer full of ice cream downstairs, so everybody takes some ice cream. There's no basic stuff, no chocolate, vanilla, strawberry, those things like Rocky Road and waffle cone and chocolate pieces. My house, the good stuff, ice cream, unless you want to put it on top of pie. So please help yourself to that. I haven't heard how it was acquired, but it has made its way here. Second, just want to get on everyone's calendar who is interested. Local Mail is here for 2 weeks, October 3rd. So if you want to sign up, contact Lee Stroud or get on the website for the American Red Cross. Volunteer to donate. We are glad that you are all here. Remind you, if you're here in person, to go ahead and sign the attendance pads. If you're out there somewhere, we are glad that you are with us as well. Through the power of the Holy Spirit, we are all united as one in this service, and we invite you out who are not here in the building to say hello as well. Let us know that you're out there, and let us know you are with us as well. So I invite us now to stand as we are able. I invite you to join me in our call to worship. There we go. In every generation, wisdom passes into holy souls and makes them friends of God and prophets. For she is more beautiful than the sun and excels every constellation of the stars. Compared with the light, she is found to be superior. Wisdom is a reflection of eternal light, a spotless mirror of the working of God, an image of God's goodness. And our opening hymn is in the faith we sing, very toward the front of the book. Praise the source of faith and learning. Thank you.
wise and understanding among you. Show by your good life that your works are done with gentleness born of wisdom. But if you have bitter envy and selfish ambition in your hearts, do not be boastful and false to the truth. Such wisdom does not come down from above, but is earthly, unspiritual, devilish. For where there is envy and selfish ambition, there will be disorder and wickedness of every kind. But the wisdom from above is first pure, then peaceable, gentle, willing to yield, full of mercy and good fruits, without a trace of partiality or hypocrisy. And a harvest of righteousness is sown in peace for those who make peace. Those conflicts and disputes among you, where do they come from? Do they not come from your cravings that are at war within you? You want something and do not have it, so you commit murder. And you covet something and cannot obtain it, so you engage in disputes and conflicts. You do not have because you do not ask. You ask and do not receive because you ask wrongly in order to spend what you get on your pleasures. And our gospel this morning comes from the Gospel of Mark, chapter 9, verses 30 through 37. They went on from there and passed through Galilee. He did not want anyone to know it, for he was teaching his disciples, saying to them, "The Son of Man is to be betrayed into human hands, and they will kill him. And 3 days after being killed, he will rise again." But they did not understand what he was saying, and were afraid to ask him. Then they came to Capernaum, and when he was in the house, he asked them, "What were you arguing about on the road?" But they were silent, for on the way they had argued with one another, "Who was the greatest?" He sat down, called the 12, and said to them, "Whoever wants to be first must be last of all and servant of all." Then he took a little child and put it among them. And taking it in his arms, he said to them, "Whoever welcomes one such child in my name welcomes me. And whoever welcomes me welcomes not me, but the one who sent me." This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Please be seated. We pray this morning, we pray together knowing that Jesus is listening, and we thank you, Lord, for being among us, whether you are among us here or helping to tie us together through your Holy Spirit into one community of faith wherever we may be. So, Lord, we ask you to look down on us, your congregation and your church, and help us to do your bidding. Help us by imparting your gift of wisdom among us, among our teams, among our groups, among our individuals, with our leaders, and with everyone who may find it in their hearts to be a leader, to find their place, their voice, their task here in our church. So Lord, all of this we pray. We pray again for our church, and we pray for our leadership. It is that time. It is late September, and we are busy planning the work of the church for 2022 and beyond. We are looking for people to serve in leadership, and we ask you, Lord, to bless us in finding those people who can fill some of those positions, and we ask you to touch the hearts of those who you need to come forth and serve. We are so thankful for all of our volunteers, all of our teachers, all of our committee members, chairs, everyone who comes in and does your work amongst us. They inspire us and they help us with our faith. So bless all of them, Lord. We pray for our country, our world. We pray for our health and others' health. We pray as we start talking once again about, flu season, that thing. Lord, it's
Believe it or not, it's going to be 90 degrees here in Omaha today, but we're supposed to be preparing for winter at this time of year, aren't we? So help us in our preparations. Help us. Keep us safe. Keep us strong. Keep us healthy. And Lord, we join together our voices, remembering the words that you, in your wisdom, taught to your disciples so long ago, and in their wisdom they passed those words on. We pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Amongst themselves about which of them was the greatest.
The Epistle of James reminds us that the battles and arguments that we have often originate from the battles and arguments we have inside ourselves. Whereas peacemakers sow peace. So Jesus calls the disciples over to teach them. He tells them that the last will be first. He tells them that to be the best, you must be a servant to everyone. Then, in an age where children were at best invisible, he put a child amongst them. And he told them, whoever welcomes such a child welcomes me. That's a poignant reminder. The great 20th century theologian Karl Barth described the basis of Christian ethics this way. To think of every human being, even the oddest, most villainous, or miserable, as one to whom Christ is a brother and God is a father. And we have to deal with them based on that assumption. Helping the helpless is helping Christ. To be Christian is not to seek greatness, but to see the greatness in others. To be Christian is to let Jesus be the authority and to treat everyone as Jesus would treat them. And another gift I received this week from my friend Claire Smith. She wrote, imagine this. You know, I've just received a message that a parcel has been delivered for you. We can all relate to that after the past couple of years. There's a parcel, and it's in the neighboring building. You respond that you will go and pick it up right away. Even though you're pressed for time, the package is important, so you rush and you pick it up before your next appointment. As you approach the building, someone holds the door open for you, but in your hurry, you barely acknowledge them. Blow through the door and you rush into the building, head up for the room where you expect the package to be. In doing so, what did you miss? You didn't notice that the person holding the door open was holding the package that you were hurrying to collect. They also had a message for you. In your haste, fueled by your concern about your time, you missed them, the package, and the message. And you missed more than that. You missed an opportunity to fully acknowledge and engage another human being. Instead of saving time, you lost time. Instead of getting your package and your message, you lost them. You return empty-handed. Dear God, please help us to always be aware of who is near and what is happening around us, lest we miss the gifts and the opportunities that you every day send us. Lord, help us to treat every single person as we would treat you. In Jesus' name. Many blessings have come through our door here at Rockbrook. Many offerings have come in. The previously jammed clothing that was here for September has been delivered, and now we'll start again, and we're ready to fill those racks again with winter coats. Yeah, again, it's going to be 90 today, but there are people out there who need winter coats. They will eventually. We know it's coming. There are many contributions out in the entryway, the food pantry, in the way of groceries, and people have also brought in money to help them out, because the pantry also supplies them with dairy and meat and things like that that we cannot put in a box and leave in our front entryway for a week until we get it delivered to them. Many offerings have come in. Our organ, it was announced last week, is paid for. As a matter of fact, it's overpaid a little bit. So we can move on to other things and perhaps shift some of that giving back to the operations. We're still worried a little bit about getting our people paid here in a week and a half. So we thank you for your generosity, for your stewardship that's been manifest to us in so many ways. So, Lord, we lift up all of these offerings. They take so many forms, they come from so many places, and they will go to benefit so many people, people whom we are challenged to understand are just like you, just like me, our sisters and brothers. Bless them in the receiving and bless us, Lord, in the giving. In Jesus' name, amen.
You have been blessed, and you will be blessed in so many ways.